welcome. This is my first little vlog. My Qiewa Q Power electric scooter finally arrived. The date specified was from the 10th to the 27th. It arrived on the 11th. So one day of wondering when it's going to be here, and then it's suddenly here. So I looked online and I see many people opening up their scooters, and they open the box and then try and lift it out. It looks awfully tight and heavy to me, so I took the easy option and I decided to cut the box away from the scooter itself. Be careful doing this, you don't hack into any wire cables or the tires. Inspection, nothing was damaged or broken. Stripping off the foam pieces. All very exciting at this point. I waited 2 weeks from order. $2,100. It's the second scooter I've had. The one I had previously was nowhere near as industrial as this. Small cracks and rocks and any bumps on the road could have you flying over the handlebars. I'm hoping that the suspension on this and the extra power will pull me through places where the other scooter just was not interested in going. So I'm being very careful here removing the plastic. I am using a razor knife. However, I don't want to cut any of the cables. I really don't want to scratch my new scooter. It's very well packed. There was no damage whatsoever. Like all the other boring unpacking, unboxing videos I've seen. Nothing very exciting. Now, assembling this scooter is very easy considering it's completely assembled when it arrives. There's no need to add any pieces on. Just lift the handlebars, pop in the little lock lever, unpacking the deck. The charger was wrapped up on there. Also in there is a little bunch of Allen keys that you might want to find and keep a hold of. I did find there was a lot of loose screws on the scooter when it first arrived. The back brake was misaligned and scraping quite badly, so I had to fix that up. And I had some trouble with one of the lights that just kept falling off riding along the road or anywhere else. It just rattled free. So I went down the hardware store and got a longer screw and some little blue goop that you put on screws to stop them rattling out. And there she is, all put together, ready to go. Now, I did stop at this point, read the instructions, and I also chose to plug it in and charge it. It only took about 5 hours to charge, and that was up to a full charge. Although the fob is there, it is a little bit confusing to turn it on. I'm still not quite sure how that's all working, and any time I push the alarm, after a couple of minutes the alarm just seems to go off. So either it's very sensitive or I'm not doing something quite right. So right about now I decided that it's probably best to charge it up overnight rather than just go for a belt around in the evening. I could wait one more night. I've waited 2 weeks. Why not?
Thank you.
Awesome.